Friends, today we'll see what are the hysteroscopic features of adenomyosis. Adenomyosis is the presence of endometrial tissue into the myometrium, that is the presence of glands and stroma into the myometrium. Hysteroscopic picture of adenomyotic uterus, irregular uterine cavity, that is endometrial surface, pseudoendometritis, that is strawberry appearance, presence of holes, diverticula or sinuses you may call, gaping tubulostria and trabecular type appearance of the fundus. Now here you can see the trabeculate appearance of the fundus. You can see opening sinuses or diverticuli, irregular surface of the endometrium, hypertrophic muscular column and strawberry appearance of the endometrium, gaping tubal ostia or preostial distortions. Now all these findings are suggestive of adenomyosis. They are not diagnostic of adenomyosis. As we enter the uterine cavity, you can see the irregular surface of the uterine cavity. You could see the endometrium, which is hyperemic, strawberry appearance with dilated white spots. Those are the endometrial glands. In the center, you could see the hypertrophic muscular column giving a trabeculate appearance of the fundus. You could see the holes, which are suggestive of adenomyosis, that is the invasion of the endometrial glands and stroma into the myometrium. These are also called as sinuses and diverticuli. Sometimes on the endometrial surface area, you could see cystic hemorrhagic areas also. This is nothing but hypertrophic muscular column. This is a hole which is also called as sinus or diverticuli. This is a hypertrophic muscular column or trabeculate appearance at fundus. Now, this is gaping ostia, which is preostial distortion, one of the finding of adenomyosis. Sometime on the surface you could see cystic hemorrhagic elevated areas. Also along with it you can find the small endometrial polyp. The most important is irregular surface area, and the best time to diagnose adenomyosis is immediate post-menstrual. Thank you.